So a big part of maintaining these new habits that we're adding to our lives is creating an environment around us that supports those new habits. And that's exactly what I want to talk to you about in today's video. I have three things that I want to share with you that are going to help you get started with creating that supportive environment for you in your journey. So the first thing on my list is something that I've mentioned before in a previous video where I shared ways to live a values-based life. And if you haven't seen that video, I'll make sure to link it here, but also in the description box down below. And if you have seen it, I'm sure you can guess what I'm going to say. But this first thing is to create a mantra for your life, a word or a phrase that represents you, what your values are, and everything in between, right? But once you create that mantra, post it everywhere. Maybe it's the screensaver on your phone or the screensaver on your laptop. Maybe you write it on a note and you post it on your mirror or your bathroom mirror so you see it every single morning. But post it everywhere, because the more you see that mantra, the more you read that mantra, the more real it becomes for you and for your life. And the more likely you are to take action on what that phrase is for you, right? So the more you see something, the more likely you are to take action, the more real it becomes for you. And that's a part of creating this balance or this supportive environment for your new habits as well. So the second thing on my list is to surround yourself with like-minded individuals. And I've talked about this on my channel in previous videos as well, where I've mentioned decluttering the toxic relationships that we have, whether it's on social media or in real life, and then surrounding ourselves with people who are supportive and encouraging. And this is extremely important because not only are you an average of the five people that you spend the most time with, but who you spend most of your time with has a very strong effect on the journey that you travel in life and how your life is going to play out in the long haul. So as you're building this supportive environment around you, make sure that you're taking care of your social life as well, because you want to make sure the people you're spending most of your time with, again, are supportive and encouraging, but they're like-minded in terms of what their interests are, what their values are, and the path that they're traveling in life. If you're headed this direction, but you're surrounded by so many people who are headed this direction, there's going to be a clash. There's going to be a tug of war there, and you don't want to be fighting against anything as you're traveling to become the best version of you. So surround yourself with people who are on the same path as you, and you will be creating that supportive environment for your new habits. So before I share the third thing on my list, if this is your first time tuning in, welcome to my channel. I talk about minimalism and intentional living, but also share my creativity and ways to build on your passions here as well. So if you enjoy either of those things or both, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below and tap the bell so you're notified every time I drop a video. All right, so the third thing on my list that I want to share with you that's going to help you create this supportive environment for your habits is to create hot triggers in your everyday routines. Now, what are hot triggers? Hot triggers are things that are going to constantly remind you to take action on those new habits or those good habits that you want to improve upon. So for example, let's say you want to work out more, go to the gym more after work, but every time you come home from work, you just get tired and you sit down, you get lazy, and you don't want to go back out after that. So a hot trigger for that situation could be to pack your gym bag the night before, put it in your car, and then once you leave work, if you pass the gym or whatever it is, then that hot trigger is that you already have your gym clothes, you're passing the gym, why not stop and get a quick workout in, right? Hot trigger. So another example could be if you're trying to have dental hygiene, right? You want to floss more often. Instead of just brushing your teeth and forgetting to floss, maybe you put the floss next to your toothbrush to create that hot trigger in your life to say, hey, I just got done brushing. Now let me go ahead and floss really quick. Now those are very simple and cheesy examples, but you get the point. Now to go on the opposite end of the spectrum, you can also create cold triggers for the things that you want to avoid doing. And if you haven't seen the video that I just posted last week about some habits you need to stop doing, I'll make sure I link that here as well. But some of the cold triggers you can do to prevent those bad habits. For example, let's say you want to stop eating junk food, right? So a cold trigger could be to either not buy junk food, but let's say you have junk food in your house already. Maybe the cold trigger is to put that stuff at the very top of your cabinet so that way it's out of sight, out of mind, right? So that way you're not tempted to eat those things as often as you currently are. But again, these are very cheesy and very simple examples, but you get the point, you get the idea. I really hope this video helped you. If it did, make sure you hit a thumbs up for me. Again, if you are new, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. And always remember to stay true to you. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.